Hello everyone, welcome back. We're taking a look at the Nioh Beta demo. This is sort of the follow-up to the alpha that we played a few months ago. They have certainly taken feedback into account for this, so we're going to continue on from where I was playing this earlier. So basically, this is the same area that was in the previous beta. From what I've read, there might be more if you get far enough. I have not gotten to that point yet, so let's get in here. So as you can see, this is the same little starting area. These little guys up here are their own kind of mechanic. Let's go to prey. So, okay, let's see. Ready jutsu. I'm not sure what this is all about. Oh yeah, so I was able to get some of this stuff. Let's see. I guess we'll try that out. So they are here, the Kodama Blessing. So you find these guys in the environment, and they provide some sort of blessing, sort of bonus to these various different sort of drop rates for like armor, weapons, Amrita, which is the money, elixirs, and ammunition. Otherwise, everything else here is pretty much the same. So, definitely one of the things they have changed here is that if you see that blue light or white light there, if you press R1, you collect it. And if I do this, if you do it right, it fully fills your stamina bar back up. Another big change, right here you'll see, actually locks on to the dude the camera does. I actually kind of thought it was a... cool idea of being able to have it lock you on, maybe attack-wise, but you being able to sort of run around a little bit. But I understand why they did this. So I have this axe and these dual katanas. I haven't used the dual katanas very much, but the axe I like because I've upgraded to get this stupid spinning move, which obviously leaves you a little bit vulnerable right at the end. But when you're fighting guys, multiple of these like dumb enemies that you see early on, it's pretty good. Especially if you can get for all three hits. So I'm curious what that fire talisman's for. We still have the same stance stuff, where it changes the attacks. So you can see, like, this is more about using the both ends. Sort of like that is like a stun. Moving into the regular attack. I'm just gonna stick with this. Because I was not locked onto anybody in particular. Yeah, so let me heal up. So yeah, kind of mostly the same demo. More just a way for people that had issues before to see that they've definitely made some changes. The combat feels a bit better. They've also made the sort of the stamina drain. If you drain your enemies of stamina, their sort of downtime is a little bit more pronounced. So we have this guy and this guy. Yeah, you can also get attacked while you're doing it. Okay, so that's what that does. It basically sets my sword on fire. Or, my axe. Another good thing about sort of trying to take some of these thing I've been doing is sort of letting these guys chase after me, because it will drain their stamina along the way. So it's sort of a good thing to sort of maybe throw a rock or something like that. There's one more guy up here. Up on the right. Yeah, it seems like most of them get their heads cut off when you take them out. I've not gotten whatever weapon needs that ammo. So where did I die? I died up there somewhere. I've seen it be a little bit spotty as far as where it puts that stuff. Yeah. As a guy, you can't necessarily attack head on. So I'm curious to try out some of the strategies. But in theory, my whatever this is, my souls. Yeah, let's try this. And the other thing about upgrading, I can't show you here, but sort of things you do is you get these skills, especially as you play these more. I guess just using the weapons more will get you samurai skill points, which you can spend on these different things here. Here we go. Got some stuff for that. Oh yeah, there's... Okay, those are just the tutorials. This is a nice, faster weapon than... Yeah, it's supposed to be like a downward stab sort of attack. Maybe that's not on this weapon. Very much like the Souls games and such. The different weapon types, as well as even within different weapons, can have special sort of movesets to them. Sort of rules and attributes. That I believe is the same here. There we go. And there is a sort of a thing where you can continually hit them after you've chopped off their head and sort of take out more limbs. There we go. Yeah, I almost died there. Yeah, I don't know if my health, or my souls are still up there. or not. And so these swords here that are sticking here are sort of ghost versions of either generic AI or other players that you can fight for bonuses and such. Got those guys so they juggled a bit. Yeah, once they fall, you can't really do much more else to them. As far as like chopping other limbs off. The other thing they added here in this beta is a specific like tutorial area. Yeah, you see I chopped off his arm and his head. Which teaches you some of the different mechanics. There's also a thing of the yokai, not the sort of level 5 kitty Pokemon thing. It's sort of like a special class of enemies that are ghosts that enact this like ghost world thing. It's kind of hard to describe without you actually seeing it. I don't think there's anything here that would necessarily show it. Yeah, so here's my grave. I've beaten this guy. Yeah, that's sort of like a finisher right at the end. When they are exhausted, you can sort of do a little finisher type move. And so I got trolled up here when I was going up on this side. There's a left side and there's a right side. There's sort of a guy that's hanging out right here. And there's a tougher guy that's sitting right there. Throw a rock, get this guy coming to me. There we go. Let's coat this thing in fire, because this guy is going to be tough right here. Oh, what? That dinky farmer got me. So there's my grave. And yeah, I don't expect to put too much time for this video. That's kind of mostly it from my perspective of playing this. Yeah, I'm not too eager to necessarily mine everything out of this. Just because when it comes out, I'm not sure if there's a date on it yet. I think it's supposed to be this fall. I'll double check while we move around. Let me see. We'll move on to here. Yeah, just 2016, I think, right now. I think we're still waiting on release date. But I think it's supposed to be this fall. At least in Japan. Yeah, we'll take on one of these guys. So this one's another player.
Fight!
I don't know what I took. It's something. I accidentally hit the wrong button. I was trying to get my piece of food. But I like that talisman stuff, my fire thing, refills. And so yeah, that's sort of an interesting little thing. Like that one seems like a tough guy because he's got yellows and blues. I guess sort of following the Diablo formula where the white is generic. Yellows are probably pretty good stuff. Despite it saying level 2. And apparently being like a 1 star. I guess that's what that... like 1 red grave out of 5 grays. So yeah, this feeds into here. Sort of keeping an eye on your items. And here are the two I'm equipping. Ooh, a hammer. I have not used a hammer. Curious to try that out. There's sort of a mechanic of familiarity, which so this is a base attack multiplier of 120 because I've maxed out the familiarity on this, the 157. And it might also add more stat stuff to it. I'm not 100% sure on that. So yeah, let's try out this hammer, put that as my main weapon. That is a big level 4 instead of this like level 3. Let's see if we got better armor to put on. Not from what I'm seeing here. No. No. No, it's the same. And so this stuff I can donate it to the to the gods, I guess, at that little temple area. What's this stuff? Okay, that's like a little grenade type thing. Yeah. Yeah, hold X to run. Shot this hammer. Okay. So yeah, I guess this is technically classified as a X since I have that dumb spin animation. Yeah, which I believe is a special move that I earned on this. Let's see. There, now, yeah, here's the spin your body into X, and I upgraded it. There's still a further upgrade. I get 100 extra life, and I can add more to that. Oh, it also has that, aspect of Dark Souls where you can have this menu and still go do stuff. Okay, that goes away when you do that. Okay. Yeah, I don't have it built up, so it's not necessarily... got off his arm. Eat. I imagine you'll find stuff to... yeah, we'll go the other direction. Yeah, I earned another samurai skill point for getting more proficiency with this weapon. Which... I guess. It might be like an overall efficiency thing. Yeah, so I'm curious what that whole limb thing is supposed to do. So there's a guy up there pacing around. Yeah, when you hear that guy yelling, you gotta run back. Cause he and his crew are coming for you. There we go. Yeah, I like that. It's just like a dumb, big dumb move. I want to get my souls back. There it is. I like how the blood builds up on your guy. And try the other path. Yeah, so we got 3,000. That's good enough for one level up. Let's see what I can do about... Yeah, and if I just knocked him down... There's this guy. Ah! I'm not sure what that is about the springs. Obviously there isn't one here, at least in this immediate vicinity. Boom, took him out. Boom. Yeah, there's another guy over there, two up here. You know, we can just run past these guys. So I'm just on a mission for my souls. Yeah, so they can still get in attacks, especially if they're not the kind that get interrupted. And also, I'm not playing too well right now, so... obviously gotta make some excuses. There's somebody has a sword thing right up here. Yeah, it still has that move from the Souls games. Oh yeah, so one of the things you can do with this game when you're getting started is sort of pick a guardian spirit. As you can see, I got that little glowing icon in the top left. That is... What button am I thinking of? Nope. I'm trying to think which button that is. No, it's not that. D-pad, no. What's that? I forget what this is. I forget how to do that. Sorry, let's pull this up real quick. Living weapon. Okay, that's right. Circle and triangle. Boom. So I get this like over exaggerated version of my weapon. Yeah, so that's what that does. Obviously, you get that building up as you kill more dudes. Yeah, so there's more enemies up this way, as you might expect from this sort of game where it just branches off. How do I have any health left? So why don't we have some time? Let's take these guys out. Might as well get some more health. Or more. And we got a guy here. There we go. Alright. So let's go back. So yeah, it's really nice that this game has improved a bit. Definitely taken more of an approach to just being more like Dark Souls, which is not a bad thing. But we've had a lot of Dark Souls. So make offerings where I can sell all my excess stuff I don't really want. I can sell that axe. And you can lock things down, so if you have like the best version of this. Let's see, my axe is locked. My best Bizenden Uchigatana. Yeah, so this stuff I can all sell it off. Dultachi. Yeah, sell it off. Yeah. Yeah, I've got lots of good stuff. Oh yeah, this all sucks. Oh, this is uncommon. Okay, there we go. Now it's giving me an elixir. I'm still not 100% sure if that is... Yeah, lock this stuff. Just to be safe. I don't think you can make an offering on it anyway because it's equipped. You can also do that with these little accessories as well. And so that adds to... You can also summon visitors. Which I'm guessing are other players. There's the guardian spirit stuff. There's three here. I don't know if they're going to add more with the full game. But they offer different bonuses and such. Level up. So yeah, I need 2500 for level up. Stamina would be a good thing to upgrade. But like as you expect, it upgrades other things as well. So I've got some stuff I can use. Spirit Stone. I should have used the other one as well. I don't think anything else here gives me anything. I don't think. I got some more of this. Yeah, and there's a whole mechanic of switching stances. During flux, I'm not 100% sure what flux is. And the other cool thing is that they have movies for stuff. So that's sort of the powerful tech thing you can do when... when they run out of stamina. I don't think I have enough for another one. I'll just double check. Nope. So yeah. And obviously doing that replenishes enemies, just in case you didn't know that about the Souls games. Yeah, there's that move there, which is like sort of you back up. Yeah, to be locked onto somebody. So yeah, that is Nioh, the beta version of this demo. Yeah, right now I'm not playing too well, but still having fun. So yeah, definitely check the game out. The beta should be over by the time this video's up. It's over on the 6th, September 6th. The game is out supposedly sometime this fall. They still haven't said anything about when that date is. So yeah. Nioh, check it out. Not to be confused for the PS4 Nioh, but I believe this is only on the PS4. Okay, do not look. But you can look at my bloody man. So thanks for tuning in. We'll see you guys again next time.